So Dan, let me ask you, do you have any rules about when you step on the mat or what somebody else should do, about being prepared, what you have to be ready with before you get on the mat to practice, not for competition, but for practice?
Few things. So, I mean, for me, it's really two quick little ones, or two or three quick little ones, right? So you could go with all three of these categories, or you could just pick one that you like. So I'll let our audience have a have hors d'oeuvres here with this thing. Is when you walk in, I personally like physical paper, but you can do whatever you want. If you're an active and engaged grappler, so anytime I've ever learned from a teacher and they've said, "Does anybody have questions?" I would always have questions. I mean, generally, if it's something that has any depth to it, I always would. So first and foremost, when you go to the gym today, what have you been watching? What have you been studying? What have you been trying to do that you would really like to figure out? And you're going to ask your instructor, one of your more experienced training partners, about this thing before you leave. It doesn't mean he needs to dedicate 20 minutes to you. It doesn't mean he has to film you a specific video or make you brownies. It just means you want to know what to do when someone does this counter from the half guard, and you want to know a few variations. Boom. So you write that down. So questions for instructor or questions for specific teammates is one category. A second category would be drills or situational matches of a specific thing. So an in-class kind of training specific. So, I'm going to get in 40 reps of my double leg today. Even if nobody's there, I'm going to just do shots. I'm going to get 40. So I'm going to go in with 40. A tangible metric for drilling or rolling is another little item you might have on this list of three. The third one would be, what are the menu items that I'm going to put on my menu when I'm doing live rolling? So what do I want to hit tonight? Do I want to go for X guard? Do I want to go for omoplatas? Do I want to go for key locks and Kimuras and really focus on tight pressure from side control? What sort of lens am I going to focus on my game today to just eke something out of my training? Andre Galvao, when I interviewed him, he does this with, he'll just experiment with different techniques that he wants to work on. Kai Otero will do this with different techniques because when people know what he's going for, they'll give him better resistance, and because he's very good, he gets better training by having them be very well prepared for the fact that he's only going for this one sweep. So, what's on your menu for live rolling? That's one. What do you want to tangibly drill or do for situational? That's two. And then what questions do you have for your instructor that you're going to ask before you leave? Well, go ahead and be as respectful as you want, but just ask them before you leave. You can pick all three of these, or you can pick one that you like. But in terms of pre-class prep, real quick stuff, I happen to like those a lot.
I do too. The one really strikes a chord with me about having questions. My feeling has always been that if you go to class and you don't have questions, you weren't doing your homework outside of class.
Yeah, or you're just not paying attention in class.
Right,
I mean,
right.
no body of knowledge really ends. I mean, when it's time to do action, it's time to do action. But at the end of the day, if it's an open-ended, concept or something along those lines, there should always be a part of your brain that can fit in one other little chunk or piece that's interesting and fascinating. And I think coming in with that ammunition is important to be an active learner.